me. Can I please talk to you for a minute?
It's your girl Gladys, aka Is That Your Hair, and welcome back to my channel.
Welcome to $20 Tuesdays.
$20 Tuesdays is a time on my channel where I showcase super cute wigs that are $20 and below. So let's get into it. So today I have a wig by Free Choice Equal, and I have her in the style Maddie. I have Maddie in the color 1B, and she comes with a typical cap construction, you know, your two combs in the front, a comb in the back with adjustable straps. On the stock card, she's worn in the middle part, but when I wore her in the middle, it was looking real Wednesday Addams-ish, and I was like, I don't really like that. So I shifted her to the side and I like her a lot better like this. This is a lace front wig and it does come with a parting space that goes back, I would say, like a good, probably like a good 5 inches. Let me give you a quick 360 of the unit. All right, y'all, so let's just talk about the pros and cons of Maddie before I go into a few tips on making her look natural. First pro to Maddie for me when I first took her out the box was the sleekness of this hair. I would describe this texture as a light yaki texture. For the price, like, it feels really nice. As I'm running my fingers through it, you can see that I'm not getting any tangling at whatsoever. You see that nape touch, Shanice? I'm not getting any tangling, so that's a really good sign. I've had quite a few synthetic wigs that were tangling straight out the pack, and I was just like, oh no, hell no. But for this to be under $20 and not tangle out the pack, I'm already impressed. Another pro to this unit is the density for me. I prefer a lighter density. Some of you may prefer something thicker. I would say this is definitely on the like 130% density side, and I love it. I think it just looks so natural. My natural hair is not this long, but seeing how it falls here, this is all the hair to the front. Look at that. Oh, I think that's gorgeous. I love that I got this in a 1B color too. I think it just adds like the sleek and sexiness that I feel in this hair. Another pro to this unit is the construction. For this to be an older unit, the parting space looks really great. I didn't have to do much at all to it except, you know, add my powder. I did put some Got to Be Glue in the parting space as you saw in the tutorial, and I flattened it down with my heating tool, which is my blow dryer. You can also use a curling wand, but I do prefer the blow dryer more now because it just kind of lays it a little faster, in my opinion. I also really love the layers in this unit. I know for me, I don't like long blunt cut units. Like, that's not my thing. You see here how it's like long layers that start here and it continues like a light feathery kind of tip, which I think looks so great. As far as cons to this unit, my only con would probably be, and it's honestly not a huge deal to me at all, but I will say it for people who might, you know, want to know, because it's a light yaki texture and because it's an older unit, I do notice like slight, very slight crinkles in the texture. I don't know if you can see it. I feel like I can see it right now. If that really bothers you, trust me, you can just take a flat iron and pass over it one time, and I'm sure that won't be there anymore. But that's my only con. I would say that this is probably medium to big head friendly. I have a medium-sized head, like around 22 inches. It's fitting me pretty comfortably on the sides here. And mind you, this is with the cap adjusted tightly. If it was loose with no adjustments, I'm sure it would accommodate a larger size head. But yeah, this hair, I am feeling it. Of course, the main pro to this unit is the price. As always, on $20 Tuesdays, I always try to deliver something under $20. And this is only $17. Yes, $17 on glamourtrust.com. If you look it up on Google and you look at any other website, you'll see it priced at $24, $25. But Glamourtrust has it for $17 in this color. However, if you do want a specialty color, they do have copper color available or platinum blonde and a few other blondes. That, I believe, costs $2 to $4 more. I'll be sure to link the hair in the description box down below, so if you're interested, you can purchase. But yes, y'all, $17 for this super sleek slay. I mean, come on. If you love long, sexy hair like this, and this is long, because for me anyway, I'm 5'3", and it comes down like past my boobies. It's definitely like a good 24, 26 inches on me. So if you love long hair, this is a wig for you. And I also like that it's beginner friendly. So if you are new to wigs, I think this is a good wig to start with because it doesn't require much. Unlike other wigs that are coming out more and more now, that requires a little bit more work, a little bit more skill. And I don't always like to recommend them to people who are beginners to wigs. But a lace front like this, yeah. This is something that you should get. One thing I did notice though was some shedding when I took out the pack. It has diminished a bit now, but I'm sure as it tangles more, you might notice some shedding too. Keep in mind, this is a synthetic unit. Even though it might look and feel a little bit like human hair, it is not human hair. So after some wears, you're gonna notice the tangling at the nape, you're gonna notice some shedding, and that's just what this type of wig does. Mind you, it is under $20. My expectations for wigs under $20 are not high. This right here is exceeding my expectations. Like, look at this. Oh my God, it's like butter. Ah! Y'all, I'm ready to go. Where am I going? Where is C taking me out? Yeah, I feel like this looks really, really good. I know some of you are waiting for some of the tips as far as how to make this look natural. I will give you a few. First tip I would say is with the parting space. One thing that I often recommend is to cut a V in your lace. You don't always have to do this, but I just noticed for me, when I do take the time to do it, it just blends even more seamlessly. And I did show you in this clip how to do that. You don't have to do that every time, like I said, but I think it's a great tip because ever since I learned how to cut a V in my lace, especially for wigs that have a line of demarcation, it makes a world of a difference. So that's the first tip. Second tip is, well, really this should be the first tip, honestly, but it's the second. Your foundation is everything. If you have your hair, you know, in plaits or twists that are not like, you know, able to become flat under your head, under your wig, it's going to be bulky. It's not going to be natural. I receive a lot of questions about how to make wigs look a little bit more natural from friends and subscribers alike. And when I ask like how they're doing their hair under their wig, oftentimes it's not in a way where the wig could lay flat in the first place. So you're already setting yourself up for failure. So make sure your foundation is flat. I do braids under mine. Well, I don't do them myself. I don't really like braiding my own hair anymore. So I go to someone to do them. She braided for me for like $25 and then I'm out the door really quick, like 8 braids. But I know people who braid their own hair. I also remember my girl Wigs to Wasteland. She came up with a video probably like 2 years ago. She did her foundation and it laid really flat for her. I'm gonna find the video and link it in the description box down below. For those who may not know how to braid and may not want to go out and pay someone to braid their hair, check out Mika's video because I remember watching it and thinking like, huh, I need to try this. Now my third tip as far as making your wigs look natural is to focus on this area right here. I'm gonna move up just a tad bit closer. When it comes to wearing wigs, I've noticed that other than when your foundation is not laying flat, it looks wiggy because sometimes the front is just a little bit funky. This wig itself lays pretty flat naturally. Even before I applied the heat, it was laying pretty well. But I do recommend paying attention to the front here by the perimeter. Now, what I've normally done in the past, I would use a tweezer and literally pluck hairs from the front to make this part lay really flat. There is a picture that I have of the Lena wig by Bobbi Boss where I did that and it laid super flat. Like, people are like, whoa. I'll insert that picture right here so you can see what I'm talking about. That was a result of me plucking the hairline and just like laying it down. It almost looks like it's coming out of my scalp. That's just like what a little bit of attention to this hairline area can do. However, I'm not gonna do that today. I'm gonna try something new because I just thought of it before I came on camera. I was like, yo, instead of plucking, why not use a razor blade? I think this would get it done a little bit faster. Even though this is already laying flat, I just wanna show you how I would do it. So literally I would, for example, just part this right here. And I would take the razor blade and just go like this and pull. I might even just do it from the top. You see how I'm doing that? Ooh, I took a lot of hair out. Okay, I didn't even take out that much, but you get the gist. Upon doing that, I'm just doing this live, y'all. I haven't tried this before. You see how it like lays a little bit sleeker? I'm gonna try to do like a side-by-side comparison so you can see what I'm talking about. But I think shaving off some of that hair makes a difference. With this wig, it may not be so much, but trust me, with wigs that are bulky at the hairline, and if you wear wigs, you know what I'm talking about. I think shaving off some of the hair at the perimeter is what needs to be done. So it's up to you how much of it you wanna shave off. Oh my God, here I go. I'm going crazy. Y'all already know how I am with scissors. Ah! I'm going crazy. I'm on the loose with the razor. And you can do it to the opposite side too. Oh my God. Okay, I didn't even take out that much hair. But you catch my drift, right? To me, doing that, especially on a bulky wig, will make it appear more sleek. It literally does become a little bit more sleek right here. Does that make sense? Please let me know if you get what I'm saying in the comments down below. If you tried this yourself, let me know. That's kind of what I did with the Bobbi Boss Lena wig, except with tweezers. That was 2 years ago. But now I'm updating my routine with a razor, and I like it. I think it looks good. Tell me what you think. Overall, I definitely like Free Choice Equal Maddie. I especially like her to the side, because when I first put her on in the middle, I was like, but like this, I feel like a baddie. Let me know if you agree with me. Would you purchase this wig? How do you feel about the tips that I gave you as far as making this wig look more natural? Do you like the way I applied it? Do you feel like it looks more natural with the shedding, the razor? Or do you feel like it's not necessary for this wig? Would you try it on another wig? Just let me know. Y'all know I love when y'all talk to me. And if you are new to my channel, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Subscribe to your girl. We are on the road to 10K and I'm super excited because, you know, it's just nice. You know, seeing that my support is building and we are like moving forward with our channel, it just makes me super, super happy and so stoked. So yes, please subscribe. Also, if you want to see some of my recent videos, make sure you check them out over here to the right of me. Thank you all so much for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.